Good afternoon, everyone, and a very warm welcome to this magnificent Barony Hall on this special day, a day of celebration for you, our graduands, and your families, friends, and supporters. This Barony Hall is one of the grander buildings on our campus and is used for a range of events, from conferences and dinners to exhibitions and exams. But most importantly, it is where we gather to celebrate the achievements of the talented people here today, our graduands. We are delighted to be joined here today by people from across Scotland, the UK, and the world. In a moment, each of our graduands will, when their name is called out, come up on the stage where I will cap them, thereby conferring them with their degree. This is an ancient public rite of passage and a mark of achievement, a sign that you are part of a proud tradition stretching back to the Enlightenment when Strathclyde was founded. Upon being capped, our graduands will become graduates of our great university. Once I have awarded all of the degrees, I will then take the opportunity to tell you a little more about our university, our heritage, and the role we are playing in the world today. Once the ceremony is finished, you are invited to join us at a reception in our learning and teaching building. I'll say more about that towards the close. But before we begin, let me say to you, please savor this moment, and to the families, friends, and supporters gathered here today, don't be shy in showing your appreciation for our graduands, and do enjoy this ceremony, which I now formally declare as open. Thank you very much. I'd now like to call on Professor Paul McKenna, our Vice Dean Research in the Faculty of Science, to present our graduands.
Executive Dean, in the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for research in the Department of Physics, Katie McDonald. Lawrence James Richard Nix. Daniel Ullman. For the degree of Master of Philosophy for Research in the Department of Physics, James Dugan. For the degree of Master of Science in Quantitative Finance, Andrea Camilleri. Jack Thomas Feeney. Lee Jing Hen. Liran Lin. Sarah Mubarak. Hamza Rasool. Sana Sharif. In advanced physics, Suzanne Michelle Eisenhofer. In applied physics, Jonathan Gray. In nanoscience, Salem Hassan S. Al-Harthy. In forensic science, Jana Abdul Salam. Hannah Aitken. Nursiafaya Imam Binti Maud Rezwan. Julia Alexandra Biskupska. Ellen Esme Bryson. Natalie Bujeha. Ross Matthew Campbell. Manhung Ryan Cheng. Ivan Mangit Choi. Artur Cleal. Francesca Artilia Donacci. Celine Farage. Demi Lee Gallagher. Camilla Caroline Hald. Ellen May Georgia Hazelhurst. Leah Sophie Hinchcliffe. Joelle Jabour. Donna Joy. Joanna Logan. John Knox McLeod. Dimitra Lydia Mavrudi. Judith Erin Marie-Louise Mitchell. Jade Louise Murray. Chukwusulum Sandra Ojima. To Chukwu Perpetua Onkonto. Carries Elizabeth O'Sullivan. Ariadne Papadakis. Athanasia Papadopoulou. Caitlin Payne. Katie Phillips. Ariana Matura Prince. Stephanie Marie Rodriguez. Constantina Rossi. Herman Sundet Rood. Carlotta Maria Silva. Ashton Elise Sweeney. Irini Taranti. Jasmine Ramos Vargas. Ellie Williamson. Taylor Riley Wood. Carmen Zabogar. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Physics, Ian Tyler McCuish. Connor Lina. Hon San Kalam Chick.
Let me warmly welcome you once again to this special ceremony and memorable day, a day that marks the culmination of many years of demanding work and dedication of our new graduates. And now that you have graduated in front of your family, friends, and peers, I'd like to begin my address by congratulating our new graduates of 2021 on their achievements and their success with a round of applause from all of us here. In a short while, you will be invited to join an academic procession when we leave this hall. This is a symbol that you are no longer students, but are now fully members of the academic community at Strathclyde, one that numbers over 175,000 across the world. You also join such esteemed company as David Livingstone, John Logie Baird, Dame Elish Angiolini, Helen Liddell, Baroness Annabel Goldie, Sir Tom Hunter. From today, you will go on to take the next steps in realizing your dreams and ambitions. It is important that we acknowledge and recognise that you are graduating at a time when the world faces many challenges. This November, we are celebrating our first in-person graduation ceremonies since the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic, which has had very far-reaching and unprecedented effects on all of our lives. This pandemic has challenged our health systems, impacted our economies, and changed the way we work. But it has also demonstrated what society can achieve when we work together. And it has placed science right at the forefront of the solutions to the challenges we have faced, are facing, and will face. For it was science and universities that delivered vaccines for the COVID-19 virus in record time, and it is science and education that will help us address the most pressing issue of our day, climate change. Earlier this month, Glasgow hosted the COP26, the summit of world leaders and nations which came together to agree measures to prevent catastrophic warming of our planet. Several important pledges were made at that gathering, and it will be up to all of us as citizens to ensure those promises are kept, to push for further changes, and to play our part in putting in place the scientific and social solutions to make net zero happen. As a university community, we are very aware of our responsibilities to reduce our impact on the planet, which is why we set a target to reduce our carbon emissions by 70% by 2025 and reach net zero by 2040 or earlier. Strathclyde is an institution where freedom of thought is encouraged and valued, an institution exemplified by tolerance and inclusion, one which seeks to play a significant role in reshaping the world we live in through our teaching, research, and through you, our graduates. Now, as graduates of Strathclyde, you too must play your part in drawing upon the knowledge you have gained here and the learning that is still to come to build a brighter future. COP also saw the former US President Barack Obama come to Strathclyde University to speak with students about the important role that the youth and young people of the world will play in tackling climate change. This former president had a simple but powerful message for those who had gathered outside our learning and teaching building to see him. Pausing in the steps, he shouted to the crowd, "Get active." And I suppose as graduates, you must champion these sorts of things and champion knowledge and address injustices too. I am confident that you will do this because you go out into the world equipped with the most valuable asset, knowledge. The Strathclyde degree that you now hold in your hands is your passport to success as you rise to meet the challenges ahead. I know that in reaching this moment, you will all have had the support and encouragement of your supporters, families, friends, teachers, and mentors. Many of them will be here today in person or thinking of you on this special occasion, and I'm sure you're extremely grateful for their support. So let us take this short opportunity to show our appreciation and gratitude with a round of applause for thanking all our supporters. In a similar vein, all of our graduates have been helped by our wonderful university staff who have worked hard to provide them with a first-class education and outstanding student experience, and for whom your success is their reward. So, graduates, please join me in showing your appreciation to them. Your success and our success as a university is in no small part due to the efforts of our staff who are delivering our vision of Strathclyde as a leading international technological university that is socially progressive.
Of all the key figures who have made the university what it is today, Professor John Anderson was the one who made it possible back in 1796, when Strathclyde was founded during the Scottish Enlightenment for the benefit of all, as a place of useful learning. John Anderson believed in knowledge for the greater good and education for all, what we now call widening participation today. And we have remained faithful to that founding principle. Strathclyde is at the forefront of widening access to higher education, welcoming those with the ability to learn regardless of their personal circumstances. This year, we met the Scottish Government target of 20% of our new students coming from the 20% most challenged areas of the community. We've achieved this while having some of the highest entrance requirements in the UK. Our ethos of useful learning continues to apply today too, as we seek to gain new knowledge and understanding what we can apply to the challenges of our day. We're a research-intensive university whose vision is to make a positive difference to the lives of our students, to society, and to the world. Through our groundbreaking research, we are helping to change the world for the better. Our scientists and researchers are leading the development of innovative technologies that will facilitate the transition from fossil fuels to the clean, sustainable energy sources, such as wind, solar, hydrogen, that will power our future world and tackle climate change. We're developing new drugs, using new digital manufacturing processes that will provide cheaper, more effective treatments in the fight against cancer, kidney diseases, and inflammatory diseases, while also helping our health services evolve to face the challenges of health and social care in the changing demographics of the 21st century. Through our focus on the entrepreneurial education, we are helping students and staff to create new businesses and sustainability with sustainability in mind, which in turn are creating jobs and supporting economic growth. We are leading the revitalization of this part of the city through the Glasgow City Innovation District, which is attracting companies, both large and small, to work with the university to create new ideas, technologies, and solutions to a range of problems in our health tech, fintech, 5G, industrial informatics, space and quantum, many others, much of which is based within our Technology and Innovation Centre. We are also growing Scotland's manufacturing capabilities as part of the fourth industrial revolution, which will see digitalisation, automation, and artificial intelligence transform the sector and provide huge economic and employment opportunities. Much of this work is taking place in the Advanced Manufacturing Innovation District, Scotland, which is out near Glasgow Airport, where the National Manufacturing Institute for Scotland facility is under construction, operated by Strathclyde. We also work to inform public policy on national economic strategies, education, productivity, and workplace strategies through our various research institutes. Our globally minded staff and students are working in sustainable development and addressing inequalities in places such as India, Malawi, and the Gambia to establish clean water, renewable power supplies, and healthcare facilities. And we understand the value of successfully working in partnership with business, government, and third sector too, and we are making a difference as we extend our global reach through our academic partnerships with other world-leading universities, including Stanford, New York University, MIT, Caltech, Tsinghua, and Nanyang Technological University, and the National University of Singapore. As a university, we are continually working to enhance our student experience, investing in our campus, as evidenced by our new Strathclyde Sport and Learning and Teaching Building, and investing in health and well-being services, putting our students at the heart of everything we do. Our progress and efforts in all of these areas have been greatly recognised in recent years with a host of awards. We became the only university to win the Times Higher Education UK University of the Year twice, having won the accolade again in 2019. We also have been named as the Best Business School of the Year at the University of Strathclyde, Workplace of the Year, and a Research Project of the Year in recent years. It's also been a significant year of progress within our faculty in science of science. And some highlights I want to just mention. Our science colleagues have been active in events throughout COP26, observing the Blue Zone, demonstrating our world-class research and innovation, providing expert commentary, attending organisations, events, and informing debates and discussions. Our sustainable research and innovation is continuing to make a positive impact. Recent examples include research in the development of new tools, which will help trees and woodlands adapt to climate change. We are also leading the way in health research, notably our university-wide Health and Care Futures Initiative. This has included extensive research into the impact of COVID-19 vaccines and a wide range of other health conditions. Of particular merit, I want to point out Professor Robertson, who has been involved with recent high-impact publications related to COVID and is a member of the Scottish Government's COVID-19 Advisory Group. His work appeared in The Lancet in May 2021 and made international headlines as one of the first studies to show the effectiveness of the COVID-19 vaccines against hospital admissions. Also, the Earth's atmosphere has been used as a laboratory to carry out a physics experiment in research collaboration involving the University of Strathclyde, which could help to improve the performance of GPS. The study displays a new method of remotely monitoring the plasma in the ionosphere, which could help lead GPS to making better calculations in the face of extreme space weather. The installation of memory and what are called repeater devices in space to enable use of the quantum internet have been proposed in research by the University of Strathclyde and an international collaboration. The study suggests that quantum memories, which actually store information in quantum form, and repeaters, which are used in the transmission of the information, can be deployed to facilitate the use of advanced internet technology. The quality of research and education at Strathclyde is why our graduates are highly sought after by employers. It is through you, our graduates, that we make our biggest impact in the world. So it is with immense pride that we see you graduate today, and though you may be leaving us, you remain important members of our Strathclyde family, and we hope that you will continue to stay in touch, to let us know how you get on, and to continue to contribute to Strathclyde's activities. It's because of that involvement with our alumni that we can provide a first-class education and student experience for you. And so we now ask that you also think of those who will follow you. Today is your day, and the time has come for you to celebrate with your loved ones. So, on behalf of the University of Strathclyde, congratulations again to each and every one of you. I wish you every success for the future.
I now declare this congregation closed and would like to invite our graduands to join the academic procession to the Learning and Teaching Building. I'd ask families and friends to remain seated in the hall while the procession is leaving the building, and then join us in the Learning and Teaching Building for refreshments. Please be upstanding.